Lucid dream interrogations. To see how the subconscious will react under certain scenarios, dreams are manipulated to place the subject in situations where they are forced to continue the dream sequence. This gives some insight into what situations the subject has been in before and predicts how he might react. People usually don't remember their dreams very well, so dream interrogations are a subtle way to probe someone's mind without them becoming suspicious. Dream manipulation is also a very powerful tool to program an individual by subconscious associations. Repetitive nightmares in connection with a political candidate, for example, can obviously change a person's opinion whether rational or not. The subject can be put into the state that one experiences just before they wake up. In this state, the subject is questioned like the way children question their mothers to get a yes from them when they are half awake. Musical interlude. A strange odyssey you have embarked upon, isn't it? The secrets that lie in the bowls of unmarked government labs are repulsive to say the least. I thought that I would take the time to share a gift with you before we journey onward. I wanted to share the insight that all that we know is made up of music, harmonies, and resonances. We are part of a cosmic symphony, energy in traveling and standing waves. One scientist even took the cosmic background radiation pattern and transformed it into the sound spectrum to hear what the universe sounded like since its birth. Ironically, it sounds like a mother's scream that is giving birth to a child. An analogous experiment I conducted was to transform my brain waves into the audible spectrum and listen to my thoughts. You will be surprised by what the music of the mind sounds like, and you can learn to control it. Eye tracking interfaces. Tammy, Satan, and Mind use eye tracking to control the interfaces. Eye trackers work by bouncing an infrared light off the eyeball or by imaging the pupil of the eyes. These interfaces make it simple enough for even a chimp to use these weapons systems. I found in my quest into the psychological community's historical research papers which postulates that schizophrenics can be identified through the psychotic eye movement frequency. Incredible how much the psychological community has been both used and duped to further the cover-up. If they were to acquire the help of current psychotronic hostages, they could look into the psychotic eye movement frequency, modeling the expected number of eye gaze changes with multiple people. They could also see that the movement of the eyes using an eye tracking correspond to exact angles and frequencies of someone who would be using an interface like I describe. But the mathematical sophistication of most psychologists is lacking to demonstrate and prove what is obvious to us who know the systems in abuse. Plus, if these tests were conducted properly, the heterodyned operators would simply go silent during them. A portable eye gaze recorder worn all the time with the visual scenery overlay would be required over a longer period of time to demonstrate and reverse engineer the menu-driven interfaces to the experimenter's satisfaction. See Hacking the Hackers for how to control Tammy/Satan operator's eye gaze and use their visual interface against them. Extracting information with brain printing. The brain print is an invention that is admissible in court. It demonstrates whether a suspect recognizes an event. Uncontrollable neural circuits fire if an event is recognized. With remote EEG readings, mental images can be presented to view the brain print guilt or recognition response. I practiced a technique similar to brain printing in order to extract the names of my assailants. Flashing letters and name fragments at high speed with our shared visual workspace, I could feel when they recognized or panicked from the word fragment. It is a subconscious response when images are presented quickly and very difficult for one to learn how to control it. Like cracking a combination, I cycled through the various possibilities until I gathered the highest probability responses and tested them further when they had their guard down. This same technique can be used for facial recognition. By morphing different human faces at a rapid rate, one can use the brain print technique to stop on faces that the EEG heterodyned mind or traditional EEG probed mind recognizes. It may be their own face or someone they know. As an example, visual word presentations based on recognition response. Hacking the mind. This is easier than a brute force password hacking program because of the feedback. It is like safe cracking. One can listen to the tumblers fall into place. UNC some response. Christopher Evans higher response. Chris Evans lower response. Christian Evanson higher response. Kevin Christensen higher response. Kevin Christian highest recognition response from the feature set of brain printing. Biopharmaceutical remedies. Higher concentrations of neurotransmitters are required to effectively perform EEG cloning at safe energies. Due to the increased amplification at the synapses, it requires less electromagnetic energy to nudge the brain into specific entrainments. There is an artificial dopamine neurotransmitter called L-DOPA. A subject could increase their susceptibility to electromagnetic influence by taking this, which is temporary and reversible with no permanent damage. Similarly, if the pharmaceutical companies could come up with a dopamine repressor or blocker, psychosis, whether electromagnetically induced, naturally occurring, or caused from damage to the reuptake mechanisms, could be cured. It would at least make the energy required to induce synthetic psychotic symptoms using modulated neurotransmitter release more detectable. Knowledge is protection. Choose life. I chose something else. Quote from a career military personnel whom I interviewed, and probably unbeknownst to him, the movie Trainspotting. Besides the technological protection methods I describe in this book against CIARHIC, MKUltra, and psychic warfare experiments, the best immunity you can have is the knowledge in this book. Some of the most important data they are collecting from these brutal experiments on people, relies on the fact that a target does not know what is happening to them. They are collecting effectiveness statistics before and after knowing of the existence of the weapon and programs. To protect your friends and family from this horror, give them this book to read and understand. Then they won't be useful for these experiments. Ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Reduce your risk, rid yourself of secrets. If you have ever worked at a secret base or on secret technology, you are at risk of being silently assassinated like myself and my colleagues in order to minimize the risk of leakage. This is often the rationalization in their twisted minds. If I could go back in time, I would have divulged all information in untraceable ways to the world, since that is what I am sure lead to my colleagues' assassinations and my tortures. Once the secrets are out, they will have no reason to kill you. Be careful that it is untraceable so that they can't pursue legal retaliation. Use spoofed email addresses and multi-rooted cloaked IP addresses, or just drop it in the mail to foreign embassies or conspiracy websites. The beautiful thing about mind manipulation technology is that you can't ever be sure whether you are giving a false confession due to memory implants or forced speech. Of course, you could always pull a President Reagan and not remember due to EDM, electronic dissolution of memories. My physical torture waned over a period of 2 weeks after I finally gave in to revealing what I knew of interest, and the whole ordeal mostly ended on its anniversary of Halloween 2005. This has allowed me to regain many of my mental functions in order to write this book. I did not publish under the pseudonym, The Saint, to protect myself from government retaliation. I have been very outspoken at conferences, rallies, and organizational meetings. I am sure that I am on every watch list invented by the conspiracy agencies. I published under the pseudonym because of the stigma attached to being tortured, raped, and brutalized. Most rape victims keep quiet, even though 1 out of 3 women are raped in their lifetime. Someone needs to teach other governments to deprogram the CIA mind control assassins, to flush out double agent that are using hypnosis, split personalities, and EEG heterodyning to pass their polygraphs and brain printing technologies. Hopefully designs of zero-emission Tempest standard labs and shelters will proliferate. If the state-of-the-art remote mind melding and CIA interrogation tactics and psychic defenses against them are known by everyone, perhaps this technology will be turned over to the people and regain constitutional controls. The goal is to make this weapon useless through education, thereby accelerating the time frame that the military/CIA will declassify and release the information to the public, so all the beneficial uses of the technology can come to fruition. According to Air Force scientists working on the weaponization of the technology, they plan to keep it secret until the year 2030. By that time, most if not all of the test victims should be dead, tortured to death for the remainder of their lives by the automated system. Stupid alien tricks. When I speak the truth and get upon my pedestal to preach, the aliens like to say, "Bite your tongue." Followed by trying to force my tongue out of my mouth while they chomp down on their teeth. Evil aliens are so immature. Warnings of mass mind control side effects. Like with any psychoactive drug, the long-term effects of neuron amplification through microwave induction or other means, will render an individual dependent on the increased stimulus. The brain's chemistry will adapt to compensate for the extra pushes that it gets from the external electromagnetic energy. If the entire population were to be put onto the TAMI network, they would become dependent on the signal since birth. If the signal were suddenly removed through a space war against the satellites or ionospheric heaters, the people would turn into zombies, unmotivated and blissfully and ignorantly compliant, more than they are now. Like Brad Pitt said in the movie Fight Club, they would be calm as cattle. They would be easy to subdue and herd. That is a nice built-in military fallback mechanism that some will experience should they find ESR, MRI, and superconducting sanctuary. Signs of psychic spying and espionage. A psychic spy generally doesn't need to be too careful these days about with whom they EEG heterodyne, because the capability is not very well known and people are still in disbelief of its existence. But in the not too distant future they will need to be more careful, for those in the know will be watching for the signs. A psychic spy will need to practice remaining still, and their eye movements will need to follow the target's eye gaze naturally. A psychic spy who sits in front of computer monitors in a comfortable chair will find themselves out of habit rocking back and forth, as many of us do. This causes a heterodyne target to rock their hips back and forth like a fidgety young child while they are standing. Although being able to control the target's eye movements is important in surveying a room, it is also detectable by those trained to observe this mixed will. All a target needs to do is try to stare at a fixed spot for a duration of time. Normally you can keep your eyes steady on that point. With one or more heterodyned minds, you will naturally get multiple urges to move your eyes in the direction of any of the other heterodyned people who are usually looking at monitors. More people in the hive mind, the less likely they can synchronize their ability to stare and gaze at a point. The other reason this is so difficult for the psychic spies to do is that their computer interfaces are driven by infrared eye trackers. Additionally, many people can hear a very artificial sounding tinnitus from the microwave energy. The tinnitus can be a very loud, steady multi-tone square wave generated above 10 kHz, or as in my case it sounds either like a Star Trek computer with a full range of pinging and bleeps, or a 3.2 Hz science fiction like phaser sound. If the auditory cortex is not mapped correctly, the target will hear crackling and hissing instead. Supposedly in the case of pure EEG cloning where the target is uninfluenced, then she/he won't have any of the aforementioned signs. However, this is much more difficult to do for a psychic spy since their mind needs to be more flexible and follow the target's brain entrainments completely. If the target thinks quickly, they cannot lock on in this mode very successfully unless there is an exact match already in the mind database. Glitch in the Matrix. A machine for every man, woman, and child? That sounds like the machine to me. Morpheus, The Matrix. One way one knows if they are being heterodyned is a thought, a visual after image, or voices repeated several times. This is a technique to synchronize the two or more EEG patterns. Everyone has to be on the same wavelength, pun intended. A snapshot of the visual workspace, mind's eye, can be captured, held, or replayed at a later time. These events are the so-called glitches in the Matrix, a necessary side effect of synchronization. Controlling and reading every person's mind requires a program specifically with their cognitive configuration. This is the rationale behind the EEG cloning and cataloging operations. There is truly a machine for every man, woman, and child working behind the curtain of secrecy. Password protection. With this type of psychic surveillance, nothing is private, not even your thoughts. Since the illegitimate and illegal powers that be are using this surveillance method treasonously on their countrymen, we must now cope with new problems. In order to protect your passwords and access to your encrypted information, you need to protect your passwords from yourself. Get a random password generating program that masks the password from your own eyes. These programs that are used mostly to store the tens or hundreds of passwords one need to access various financial, email, and other accounts on the internet also prevent this kind of password stealing. You only need to know one password to access the main encrypted database which is stored locally on your computer. So it would be very difficult for these spy agencies to steal your passwords and access or modify your accounts from another location. They would need to physically break into your dwelling to gain the data. Angular modulation of radar reflective surfaces. To disrupt the synthetic aperture, full spectrum radar and imaging techniques, changing the reflective direction of the radar signals makes it difficult for them to adapt to the environment. Using material as simple as mylar, metallized plastic film, loosely surrounding a shelter with a fan blowing changes the deflection angles of the radar. It only works for a limited frequency range, but reduces the effectiveness of their imaging and influencing techniques. You can think of this technique as similar to stealth technology using M-radar dampening material, sharp deflection angles, MRI/ESR field gradient disruptors, and electron gyro frequency noise generators, scalar interferometry distorters and superconducting magnetic mirrors. Changing the specular reflection angles of the incoming radar signal through mechanical modulated plates will change the radar signature enough to throw off some automated tracking algorithms. Super shields. An alchemist friend gave me a recipe to help us deflect the witch's hypnotic spells. He said to use a smidgen of yttrium, a dabble of barium, and a pinch of copper in the ratios of 1:2:3. Smelt it in the fires of Vulcan at 1000 degrees Celsius to forge a superconducting shield which when cooled by the breath of Zephyr to 77 degrees Kelvin will protect us from the witch's hexes and spells. Superconductors have the special property of being a perfect magnetic mirror. This is why a magnet will float on top of them. For magnetic brain readings at Lawrence Livermore Laboratories, they had to use a superconducting shield to block the external noise for their SQID readings. A superconductor slab creates an electric current that exactly opposes an impinging magnetic field. Research into thin-film superconductors will eventually yield cheap and affordable scalar radar and magnetic resonance shields. But if the evil aliens have selected you for torture experiments, then a rather expensive superconductor chamber with electric field disruptors may be your only refuge. Perhaps our political leaders will wisely decide to super shield Congress and the White House to avoid undue electromagnetic influence from the conspiracy or foreign governments. Of course, blackmail will always be effective. Juries and judges will someday need their chambers super shielded for the same reasons. Dispelling myths. Thanks to the MIT professors and students who worked to dispel the disinformation agents' much-promoted aluminum tinfoil beanies myth, which were claimed by movies and websites to protect one from the directed energy weapons and brainwave reading. It turns out that the aluminum acts like an antenna and actually enhances body resonance signatures in the suspected FCC-allocated military bands. However, many have gotten relief from the M-radar noise that causes symptoms from mild discomfort to outright torture by grounding mylar-shielded rooms. See the guide on radar, scalar interferometry, hypnosis, electron spin resonance disruptors and shielding in the appendix. The source of the killing signals. Interesting to note that ionospheric heaters have popped up all over the world. Arecibo, Puerto Rico, built 1953 to 1960. Fairbanks, Alaska, HARP 1990. Tromso, Norway. Ukraine. Russia. Tajikistan. Brazil. Armidale, New South Wales. Platteville, Colorado, 1969. Australia. Chicamarca, Peru. Millstone Hill, Massachusetts. Here are some of the listed capabilities of these facilities. Incoherent scatter radar, stealth scalar radar. VHF radar, operating within brain resonance frequencies. UHF radar, operating within head resonance frequencies. HF receivers, operating within body resonance frequencies. Fluxgate magnetometer. Induction magnetometer, possibly useful for detecting the low-intensity magnetic field brain manipulation methods in case another country tried to use them on the shadow government. Stimulated electron emission observations, this is similar to ESR imaging techniques. Gyrofrequency heating research, this is another ESR MRI-like imaging technique. With a variation that might be used in the imaging over large areas using synchronized gyro frequencies for M absorption or reflection angles. Spread F observations. Heating-induced scintillation observations, another surveillance technology. VLF and ELF generation observations, brainwave frequencies. Radio observations of meteors and ballistic missile reentry. Strange how we spend so much money on looking at meteors in the sky, but seemingly don't take interest in relieving the suffering here on Earth. Perhaps we should take the efforts to observe the universe with a grain of salt. It is just another way to couch technology development for military applications. Actual picture of the HARP mind reading and influencing and over-the-horizon radar facility being constructed in 1990, sent to me by a saint who worked on it. The largest phased array in the world stretches beyond what the eye can see. This is not the field that has tortured the most Americans. Brazil's or Puerto Rico's ionospheric heaters are the most likely candidates. But they are all integrated now into the global human surveillance grid that I was duped into helping integrate. So, this spread of terrestrial high-powered extremely large antenna is very suspect. While satellites could be involved in the integrated worldwide surveillance of human beings, it may be difficult for them to generate the power of the directed energy over the area that I measured during the severest attacks on me. My back-of-the-envelope calculations from the power output and Gaussian distribution over the area targeting my neighborhood gave me a figure above 500 kilowatts that greatly depended on how far the field extended. This is within the power ranges of most of the ionospheric heaters listed earlier. There are other coincidences. I deduced the methods of surveillance through many simple experiments during the year of the attack on me, which happened to correspond to the capabilities of these so-called ionospheric heaters. More suspect behavior on the part of the military is that the two over-the-horizon radarospheric heaters are based about equal distance from the continental. The United States' total internal reflection from the ionosphere is optimal for power transference from antenna to target arena. So the best guide to pinpointing when and where the first mind control radio network was established is to follow the trail of possible victims back in time and look at when the mass media streams began prepping the population for the human experiment trials. While I stated in the introduction that TAMI came online in 1976, that was only one system. There were earlier ones. John Nash, Nobel Prize winner, and made famous by the movie, A Beautiful Mind, worked for the NSA then apparently had sudden onset schizophrenia afterwards. This is a suspect case. It seems too intentional in its message, really smart people who worked on top secret government projects can become crazy overnight. His illness began in 1960. That is the date that the Puerto Rico ionospheric heater came online according to several documents. HARP is often implicated in the mass torture experiments that the United States is conducting, but it didn't come online until 1990 and is probably only a backup system or meant to cover a different portion of the world. Remember that the mind control technology came from the Nazi scientists that were smuggled into the United States after World War II, in 1945. The TV series, The Outer Limits, began broadcasting a common theme in almost every episode in 1963. Every episode deals with evil aliens, psychic mind control, abductions, futuristic technologies and zombification or mental enslavement from aliens. The DOD and CIA are not an extremely creative group. The evil alien propaganda has worn thin by today and completely overused. Satanic cults, demonic possessions, poltergeists, and other wacky ridiculous stories are now in vogue to dupe the gullible masses and help those they torture and kill for data to cope with the betrayal of their government and people. However, mental illness is still their golden psychological mass mind program. Interestingly, those closest to the evil elements like enlisted men are the most likely to believe the technology and brutality, while doctors are the group quickest to jump to the programmed response and irresponsible diagnosis of mental illness. Nash may have been a threat because he wasn't working on cracking encryption codes as the movie contends, he was probably working on decision matrices and game theory for military applications or even for cognitive modeling and psychology of mass persuasion. His research interests were not in encryption like the movie would have you believe. He won the Nobel Prize for his work with game theory and optimizing decision models such as the famous Nash equilibrium used in economic theory. You can see how cognitive decision modeling would be more up his alley and aligned with the development of this system. He could have posed a major threat of leakage to civilian researchers or continued advancement on his own ideas. Another interesting coincidence is that Nash was forced into insulin shock therapy by his wife, which was used to treat psychosis in that day. Insulin shock therapy is another way to torture and split a personality, thereby erasing the memory of the person or at least making the memories inaccessible. Directed energy weapons can be used to induce diabetes, as I stated earlier, based on the World Health Organization literature. One victim got diabetes and then was manipulated into inducing insulin shock therapy through EEG cloning by messing with that person's ability to sense the symptoms of going dangerously low in blood sugar. Nothing has changed with their techniques other than it can all be done with EEG cloning remotely and with better plausible denial. So, the low-hanging fruit if the people ever get fed up with tyranny, the illusion of freedom, and being killed and plucked off the planet to be an alien weapon test decimal point, they may want to organize in order to defend themselves and try to fry the electronics of all these research facilities simultaneously. Be creative, find a way to stop this. Poison space if disabling these antenna fields fails to stop the worldwide tortures. Build superconducting shielded rooms. I put the recipe in the appendix to make your own relatively cheaply. Build ESR and MRI field jammers. Stop the subterranean half-humans. I also put a list of joint command and control bases in the appendix that are suspected of housing many of the traitors. The rumor is that many of EEG cloning army is located in a Californian semi-secret base on the edge of Death Valley, near some mountains where there are 50 miles of underground tunnel and a very large signal intelligence and communications war room. The evil aliens are most likely kept in their cages there. I thought that I'd mention it in case people who are being tortured want to speak to their killers face to face. Two twin girls who were tortured and made into CIA split personality spy slaves were used to assassinate people and prostitute themselves to the politicians in order to collect blackmail so that the United States politicians could be controlled by the executive branch of government. Also wrote a book called Secret Weapons. I highly recommend it for another true story and perspective on the depravity and shameful heritage Americans sweep under the rug. Another apology. Again, I must reiterate. I know that I blast whole groups of people with generalizations of occupations, affiliations, and organizations. I apologize profusely to those people who happen to fall into one of the categories that I scold but who do not fit the mold. Just remember, if the ruby slippers fit, wear them, Dorothy. Stupid human tricks. so to make the ignorant public, that's you, more aware of the voice of God technologies that exist and are being used to manipulate religious groups and the like, I will be pranking people with ultrasonic directed acoustic heterodyning and a parabolic microphone like the setup the Japanese candid camera show I mentioned earlier had. At a reasonable distance, I will be able to project my voice at an unsuspecting person, and if they respond out loud, I will be able to hear them. But, I will be nowhere in sight. If you suddenly begin hearing aliens, satanic cults, God, or dwarfs speaking to you and your friend next to you doesn't hear it, it might be me if it lasts only 30 seconds and I tell you that you have been pranked, or much worse that it is the usual suspects in the United States government and you will be tortured for years. People who have experienced the three types of voice-to-skull technologies can distinguish between the sounds, but few are experts in all them all. Hopefully the message will get out. It is incredible how much people rely on those little boxes called TVs for their reality. When I describe the details of how widespread EEG cloning experiments are, everyday people almost always respond, "Well, if that's true, why haven't I heard about it on the news?" Just what if the news wasn't allowed to talk about certain topics and the information streams were controlled as tightly as we think communist counties' information to their population is controlled? The news wouldn't publish the thousands of people's claims who the government fed radiation to either when it was happening. Nothing changes except the delusion of democracy get better as the actuality furthers. Entrainment disruptors. The microwave hearing effect can be overpowered by another signal. It looks like individuals need to be tuned. Simple acoustic binaural beating jammers also work somewhat to weaken the focus of attention on the integration of the signal into voice. Breaking the hypnosis and electromagnetic trance of rhythmic bass brain waves can be done temporarily by focusing on non-rhythmic sound patterns like this logarithmic clicking sound file, repeatedly. Experiments with signal strength and disruption. Like with cell phones, which frequently encounter dead spots or lost connections, the direct brain link on the mind network also encounters noise or dropouts. But unlike with audio noise, neural noise is perceived much differently. And unlike a dropped cell phone connection, the communications re-establishing technologies like multipath and adaptive signal strengthening and background noise estimation very quickly re-establishes the link. I found what I jokingly refer to as psychic protection points. These are geographic spots that for some reason interfere or reduce the neural link strength. The San Francisco Bay Bridge has at least two spots while driving over that cause the neural link to drop out. Unfortunately, you can't walk across the bridge to stand in those zones. A dropout of an EEG heterodyned neural link simple feels like a relaxing or quieting of the mind, less neural chatter or babble from the participant minds. A noisy neural link doesn't cause a hissing or white noise like sound in the synthetic telepathy, but rather takes on different forms depending on the focus of attention. If the brain stops interpreting the tinnitus or tauss hum, due to misalignment of the energy pulses or unequal binaural perceived sound match as voice, just the hum or melodic tinnitus is perceived from very subtle or up to 120 decibels. But if one uses mylar and other metallized synthetic polyurethane deflection and absorption shielding around their body, they will perceive non-sequitorial thoughts and images ever so slightly, or even the microwave hearing effect words can become garbled, sounding like a computer-generated random sequence of phonemes. However, the disruptive shielding effects and degaussers are usually only temporary and the neural link is re-established by the very impressive adaptive algorithms, much less prone to disruptions due in part to the low bandwidth requirements. Voice can go as high as 10,000 Hz, but brain bandwidth can be as small as 2,000 Hz. In addition to the low bandwidth requirement, the brain has a natural tolerance for fleeting errors. The information is encoded in the timings of the pulses and compressed in the complexity of the brain structure itself, paragraph, sentence, and word of a book, each adding context to the information stream. The information is already almost all contained in the book, it just needs to be referenced in some order to create new thoughts from that previous work. You can see how a brain link has some encryption and compression built into its very nature. Only the person who holds the private key, that is the cognitive map of the target, can decipher the signal, and since the deciphering key changes at every moment in time depending on the current brain state, interception of the signal is almost worthless to normal signal intelligence interception methods. Unfortunately, many victims have been tricked into believing that if they shield their computers and monitors better, it will cut down on the near-field antenna effect. They have been trained by pain signals to believe this. All extra electromagnetic noise is good at reducing the signal-to-noise ratio for reading bioelectricity. Similarly, most have been trained not to sleep on spring mattresses. The coils probably interfere with their signal-to-noise ratio too. Blinding the cyclops. By using fixed-location phased array antenna fields, one can create directed energy that appears like it is coming from any direction. But in fact, the antennas are fixed. They can bounce their energy off of surfaces like the ionosphere. But the directions of the intersecting heterodyning beams are really stationary. That means the killing signals have an exact direction that can be calculated by ray tracing your location to the ionosphere back to the 4 or 5 directed energy antenna fields, aka over the horizon radar. Those are the directions you want to block to weaken the nervous system disruptor or the surveillance system's secondary effects for electrically sensitive individuals. Another idea is to blind the cyclops. By blocking one of the intersecting beams, even if they have a very small angle between them, you can then detect the gravity wave or carrier signals, that is pinhole photography. Even if the carrier signal is hidden in deterministic broadband noise, you should be able to amplify it and direct it towards the ionospheric heaters. By amplifying the carrier wave and rebroadcasting it in the right direction, the signal-to-noise ratio would be nearly completely brought down to zero and your bioelectric information can no longer be read with this technique. Detecting scalar, interferometric, gravity waves or scatter radar. Rather than go into details of the many methods used to disentangle the two or more nearly perfectly aligned canceling carrier signals, I will just point the interested reader to the United States Patent Office for Scalar Wave Detectors. Number 6,753,690 Interferometric Signal Processing Apparatus. Number 6,420,872 Probe for Detecting a Transient Magnetic Resonance Signal, wherein the ratio of the Q of the probe to the Q of the resonance signal is relatively large, filed by the Secretary of the Navy. Always look at patents filed by the DoD with a critical eye, strategic deception is often the purpose. But this patent looks plausible. Here is a basic scalar wave detector design. Normally the waves destructively interfere and create a nearly zero electromagnetic field reading, but by putting in pinhole lens perfectly aligned, one can get a focused image of one of the sources in a phased array. The difficulty is the wavelength can change, and if satellites are used, they are probably moving targets. If ionospheric heater phased arrays are the main source, then the task becomes much more practical by the armature investigator. Portable bioelectric field scramblers. Don't cross the streams. Crossing the plasma streams is bad. Ghostbusters. Wrong advice. Mixing the plasma is good to rid yourself of the ghost in the machine. Disrupting the electron spin alignments using ion generators works to weaken ESR surveillance and EEG cloning attacks. Since ESR/EPR, electron spin resonance/electron spin polarity resonance, technique is one of the major methods of monitoring citizens' brain activity, one should be hypothetically able to build a portable device that scrambles the ionic heating of the body's surface charges. Something as simple as an irregular astable high-voltage oscillator with skin contact may do the trick. However, the high-voltage ionic charges may not migrate away from the point of skin contact, so something like a thin wire threaded conducting jacket may be necessary to provide a larger area of field disruption. The idea is to lower the signal-to-noise ratio containing the modulated bioelectric field information in the ionic electron gyroformation contained in the electron spin. This is why magnetic jewelry items are so popularly worn to alleviate pain for millions of people who are sensitive to the global human surveillance system's biofield reading mechanisms. However, the magnetic jewelry has a static magnetic field except when one is moving. The adaptive filtering algorithms of the system will rather quickly learn to filter out any steady or regularly oscillating signals. As a side note, I want to dive into Russian theories of biocommunication in their psychic research from the late 60s. The entire field was a study of how neuron electrical fields could be picked up, amplified and received by someone else. The first breakthrough was using EEG probes to read the brain's electrical activity and modulate it with high voltage electrical fields around a person who was placed in a sensory deprivation tank for a week or longer. The person who was in the sensory deprivation chamber would begin to interpret the electrical modulation as his/her own sensory organs. So it was learned that the human brain is adaptable enough to interpret almost anyone else's electrical brain patterns as their own. This is the sixth sense phenomenon. Except in this example, the psychic or person in the sensory deprivation chamber is like Helen Keller and has no senses of their own, so this is pure EEG cloning, or in other words a substitution of their own senses and some higher level cognitive pathways mimicking the external brain signal. Monkey see, monkey do. We cannot escape our 96% DNA similarity to chimpanzees. It is an inherent property of self-organizing neural networks. This is why we conform, why fads spread, why culture exists, and traditions feel good. Psychic spies are like dummies or scarecrows. They are just receptacles for someone else's brain signals. Due to the sensory deprivation to make their brains entrain on the external signals, they become stupid or brain dead if and when they are disconnected from the signal. Our military was merely supposed to be a bunch of scarecrows to frighten off other countries from invading. What happened? Why are the scarecrows the aggressors? Why do they get positions of power in the government? Once it was known that human brains are mostly compatible and can learn anyone else's patterns, it became weaponized. Inducing one or more brain patterns into someone could also be done. This is just like piggybacking various brain signals. It matters not whether it is a voltage gradient on your skull or a synaptic voltage from a nearby neuron. It is like stealing that person's soul. Body Snatchers might have been another movie inspired by the large testing of the world's population of this weapon. Killing someone psychically is probably the most cowardly act in human history. Even the lion from The Wizard of Oz had more courage. See the section on psychic assassinations. And I'm sure the Tin Man had more heart than any of the scum in the United States CIA/DIA/military that continues the MKUltra tortures and artichoke programming of assassins to do their dirty work. Thousands if not more are tortured under this program, but you will never hear about it in the very controlled information streams. I'm so proud of what my ancestors fought and died for, to create a country based on lies and torture. If only we had a little more secrecy, we would all feel safer. See playing fascist gods, they are unimportant. Ionic heating frequency scramblers. There are two possible mechanisms of action in order to heat the ions so that their electron gyro frequency and angular momentum are synchronized, or that they create the high electron voltage necessary to induce neurotransmitter release. First, there is a microwave frequency that causes ionizing to occur. Secondly, electrical body resonance or head resonance would induce the desired gyro frequency alignment. The body electricity would be modulated into the stealth radar return intensity like a flickering candle or a twinkling star in the distance. So there must be a way to de-sonnet the body and head using their unique resonance frequencies. Perhaps messing up the ionizing frequency will also decrease the effectiveness of the surveillance technique. All these techniques will work under low-intensity directed energy, but could probably be overpowered if all the energy from these radar fields were focused on a very important target. If I only had a brain, the scarecrow effect. It should hypothetically be possible to record samplings of your own brain waves and modulate an external electric field with it so that the targeting and tracking mechanism would get confused and follow the EEG decoy, assuming you have no biotelemetric implants, GPS chips, or chemical markers. Since many methods are employed for surveillance of civilians, similar decoy methods would need to be implemented to throw off infrared thermal signatures, magnetic signatures. Body/head resonance mannequins might be needed, as well as traditional radar absorption and reflection signature alterations. Heart rhythm signatures can be fooled in a similar fashion to brain print signatures. I even worked on a technology that identified people by their unique gait. Stealth bomber radar absorbing insulators. Teflon has unusual insulating and charge collection properties that make it somewhat impermeable to ESR techniques or bioelectric modulation. A Teflon-like material is used on stealth fighter planes. Saran wrap is also a synthetic polymer with similar properties, and sure enough, it does prevent some ionic heating and has similar ESR radar absorption properties since it doesn't conduct. Thermal signatures can be thrown off by electronically controlled Peltier junctions used to cool microprocessors. Scintillation techniques could be shielded by superconductor material. Remember that the radar fields are directional, but they can bounce signals off other material in order to reach the target. There are several more sensing technologies that you can read about on most physics websites, such as NMR, nuclear magnetic resonance, sister techniques like nuclear quadrupole resonance, NQR. The object is to reduce the signal to noise ratio of all the tracking mechanisms in order to escape from the United States virtual hell and the global human surveillance grid. Full spectrum or broadband radar. Another reason the biocommunication and surveillance technologies are so difficult to lose is that every wavelength is observed. So even if one blocks or jams several of the frequencies, there is always more of the spectrum. Here is what a ping from a broad spectrum radar pulse might look like. A radar ping with an exponential intensity decay at one frequency would help the imaging software more easily figure out at what depth the return is from and compensate for any nonlinearities in transmittance, absorption, or reflectance of a material. The recorded readings from many government tortured test subjects' houses had a variation of this waveform. Its ping started at a high frequency, then progressed to a low energy, low frequency with a lower energy continuous sawtooth waveform background. This actually makes more sense given the mathematics from radio communication theory of the energy spread when heterodyning or modulating a progressively lower frequency to create a lower sideband. Or in simpler terms, sweeping a high-frequency carrier range of one of two heterodyned beams would create this lower-frequency combined waveform. It is a combination of every frequency up to some point. It could take the appearance of a broad background noise, or in order to segment the frequency ranges better, it might skip logarithmically up the frequency domain. Even square waves or sawtooth radar signals create good broadband returns because every square waveform is made up of the infinite sequence of every odd harmonic, and the sawtooth is made up of every harmonic, which gives a nice sampling of frequencies across the spectrum. Low probability of detection, scatter radar. Ion heating. During a severe directed energy attack, CCD, charge-coupled devices, cameras become somewhat disabled due to the charge buildup. During hoodings, the air becomes electrified, that is ionized. Knocking an electron out of orbit or just raising it to the outermost electron valence shell can be done with specific frequencies and thereby create ions, some negative and some positive. This is what the ionospheric heaters do. Once static electricity, ions or cold plasma, is created, the single electron orbits are used to amplify electron spin resonance signals and reading methods for the synchronized gyro frequency of the electron orbits, as well as traditional ion reflectance spectra. See the appendix for an example of how NASA tricks astronomers and cosmologists into developing weapons by saying they are interested in observing meteors in the ionosphere. They are so bold with their hints of the real uses, that they call the ion flash of a meteor the size of a baseball upon impact the head echo effect when observed by the Puerto Rico ionospheric heater / over the horizon radar. That is exactly what it is used on human heads, not just meteors. They told the researchers that they can't look more than 20 degrees from zenith due to physical restrictions of the setup. The real reason is that the radar signal passes into space at those angles and frequencies, but they bounce back to Earth more than 20 degrees from zenith. The head echo effect location and tracking is exactly the same for human tracking. The flaws in the algorithms described in this paper are the same ones I discovered from my own experimentation. How can we play the same game as the government with the secret NSA domestic spying? We can organize a flood of the echelon system with false positives. Or use the method of autostereogram message passing to bypass them completely. A multi-billion dollar system is completely worthless at detecting anyone who tries to defeat it. It monitors your average citizen quite well though, and helps bloat government with lots of federal government welfare jobs who get to pretend they are useful. Ideas to take out the weapons of torture and global tyranny. Spraying an orbiting cloud of ferromagnetic charged and magnetized particles at low Earth orbit, counter rotation for impacts and blackouts of the satellite systems capable of being used for psychotronics would probably work. Large ground-based solar ovens or lasers to lock on and heat the satellites above superconducting temperature might cheaply knock them out. Satellites over other countries' airspace that can emit psychotronic weapons signals or directed energy should be shot down, since they are an immediate threat to their country's security. The internet has proven to be the most important vehicle of truth. I commend Google and other search engine companies for continuing a high standard of integrity for the quest of truth. The right to free speech is being trampled on by algorithms flooding the internet with disinformation to drown out the truth. I devised AI natural language parsing algorithms to parse out truth from the method used to supplant it. By the way, type in miserable failure into Google to see a biography of George Bush. Plead to the public. I hope America appreciates what I am doing by going public with this information. Since I was tortured for a year by something far worse than what McCain experienced and thrown into one of these secret mind control prisons for just being too knowledgeable, I imagine I will surely get a secret death sentence for telling the truth in a publication. I am hoping that more public exposure makes me safer instead. But monthly, I get the reports of how many psychotronic victims have perished, and it doesn't look good. Poisoning space. The United States has 413 satellites and the rest of the world has 382. Because the United States has taken the course of installing many space-based weapons, irresponsibly turning the pristine space into a battlefield of directed energy weapons, other countries should protect themselves by poisoning the airspace so the energy can't focus. Also create scalar wave detectors and bounce directed energy off the ionosphere back to the 15 or so ionospheric heaters to blind them. Here's an idea how. There are 8,000 tracked objects greater than the size of a golf ball. A ferromagnetic charged particle cloud at 480 kilometers, 300 miles, above the Earth's surface would greatly reduce remote sensing capabilities and targeting capabilities with directed energy weapons. There are no laws that any country abides by in space. So putting up anti-psychotronic shields which would disrupt other satellite services too would be a smart defense to counter America's expansionism phase, and to stop their soft kill weapons of assassination. Publicity stunts. we are left with no choice but to employ more drastic measures in order to raise awareness, get noticed, and have the problems addressed, since the mass news streams refuse to pick up this story or broadcast the many peaceful protests, and no government agency has responded to the thousands of letters these organizations have written. We are planning the coordination of blocking major thoroughfares in all the metropolitan areas with trucks and protest signs. We have organized call centers, dialing over 700 people a day, and are sending emails worldwide at a rate of 20,000 a day. We are renting high-powered argon lasers to project our message in the sky simultaneously in all major cities around the world. This is just a list of a few of the activities going on to awaken the sleepy minds that need to be vigilant as to what is occurring in order to expose and hopefully stop it. Saddening that something as horrific as domestic torture and federally sponsored terrorism against its own citizens can't be immediately addressed in a civil forum. We are also compiling a name and Facebook of all those suspected in aiding and abetting in these programs, from scientific researchers, to CIA trainees stalking gang members, to irrationally skeptical politicians that block laws to protect its citizens. The Facebook of the conspiracy will be distributed to other countries in hopes of ending the careers of those agents involved. The promised land. Land ho. Quickly, take a gander through the looking glass of time and see what rewards are in store for humanity's future once we have defeated the witches, spooks, zombies, and devils. We can return to the Garden of Eden, the perfect world of our very own design. We take our rightful place as gods of ourselves. Perhaps that's what we were all the time. Men at some time are masters of their fates. The fault, dear Brutus, is not in our stars, but in ourselves, that we are underlings. Shakespeare, Julius Caesar, Act I, Scene 2. E.g. Heterodyne learning efficiencies. We are doomed to repeat the mistakes of the past. Be it the current Mgultra-like human torture and experimentation by the DOD or politicians not heeding the warnings of the collapse of other civilizations past. This inability to pass on all of human knowledge to the next generation continues to plague our progress. It is the death toll of the human race, for machines never forget. E.g. cloning is the ultimate teaching tool. The learning process is greatly expedited both through shared understanding and mimicking the professor's brainwaves, not just through speech but conceptual communication takes place too. In the shared visual cortex space, 3D images and animations can instantly be shared and understood without the time-consuming process of making slides and visual simulations. In the Matrix, this feature of EEG heterodyning was symbolized by the heroes being able to upload knowledge of operating a helicopter almost instantly. But of course, the less noble route of this technology development is occurring. They are using this accelerated training to train brains into delusional thinking and psychotic symptoms. They have found that they can actually teach a brain directly how to misthink through brain entraining. This is useful to cause errors in judgment and perception in the enemy. Refer to the appendix for the Air Force description. This will also help with the cover-up, not only to discredit the individual victim's testimony, but once perfectly shielded from the electromagnetic influence, it may take some time for those mind to adjust back to their natural normal thinking patterns. However, if the DOD would just release this technology to the world for all its potential, they too could get a lifetime of the best education in a mere fraction of what it took current scholars, and they would see the world not as a conquest for power but as a life form to nourish. Tomorrow is another opportunity to turn it all around. Vanilla Sky. A rare example of a smart alien trick. So one of the benefits we discovered of EEG cloning is the ability for multiple minds to convey complex concepts quickly to each. It is the ultimate teaching tool and could allow education to be absorbed in a tenth of its current time and effort. But there is a dark side to it. That is, if one doesn't know they are part of a hive mind collective, they can be led down a path of scientific errors. Common errors of logic are being mapped so that the scientific discovery process can be stifled or delayed in the civilian world. Below is considered a complex model of our universe which unifies gravity with electromagnetic field theory. Grand unified theories have been around since 1920, and Einstein died while trying to solve this puzzle. I don't know much about advanced physics, but it seems plausible to me. Here is what was conveyed to me via the mind meld and synthetic telepathy, I imagine as an example of scientific espionage. Gravity travels at the speed of light. Gravity weakens by the square of the distance like a point of light. It appears that gravity behaves very much like electromagnetic energy. Why? Gravity attracts based on the energy density. Force of attraction equals gm1m2/r2. Or substituting E equals mc2, where m1n2 is just a standing wave of energy. GE1E2/R2C4. This is not inconsistent with known observations. A black hole that only swallowed huge amounts of light would still grow in mass and still bend light traveling nearby. It is energy density that bends space/time, not just mass. Field energy, or gravity waves as they are nicknamed, are created by intersecting nearly perfectly aligned beams of energy 180 degrees out of phase with the same intensity. So one could conclude that gravity is just a special case of electromagnetic field theory where a positive field is cancelling the negative field. The frequency of the fields would be irrelevant except for the amount of energy contained in it, and hence the frequency of a gravity wave is simply based on the mass or energy density which generates it, and hence its intensity. So with a light photon or quantum, E equals lambda asterisk constant. Equivalently, lambda equals mass quantum slash constant. So the immeasurable frequency of a graviton, quantum, is inferred from its mass of origin. If this were true, you can create a localized time distortion with a really intense directed gravity, scalar field. Relativistic effects would apply to the localized field. You can create a tractor beam and even bend light if you can create an energy density greater than that of matter. Or create matter out of energy. This is where science future writers get their ideas, like replicators, transporters, tractor beams, and time travel machines. The intensity in order to do these things is obviously too great for current technologies and energy sources unless fusion has come of age. Another field of science that seems to have lost the interest of the public. Plus, the slightest error in the cancellation of the two energy sources would fry the target. The question is, what is wrong with this grand unified theory? The first question would be, if there is no particle exchange, this would be like free energy being emitted by the standing mass wave. However, you don't need particle exchange to explain where the energy comes from. Just like we found that mass and energy are the same, we will find out that space/time and energy have their equivalents. The expansion of the space/time continuum requires energy and cools off the temperature of the universe. The expansion of space around energy is slower, that is general relativity. Time progresses more slowly and space contracts. It is this drag on the expansion of space/time that creates the gravitational wake of free energy. It isn't free though. Energy is still conserved, it is just converted from the momentum of space/time. This would allow us to calculate the momentum of space/time dilation, that is the tensor of energy per unit area/time stretch of the manifold. The graviton as a particle has never been found. Unifying general relativity's geometric interpretation of the universe and the standard model of particle physics has always posed a hurdle for physicists. Now, to consolidate quantum effects, we need only apply the rules logically. Since it is known that mass is energy, and momentum of space/time is energy, and gravity is another field created from the drag on space/time momentum, then we should expect that gravity and space/time have quanta. This might be defined both by the Heisenberg uncertainty principle and Planck's constant. That's all they conveyed to me. It makes you wonder if John Nash, Nobel Prize winner, thought of his ideas before or after he was part of a hive mind and diagnosed with schizophrenia. This is a good example of the wireless global brain project and how the CIA plays Robin Hood with intellectual property. So we now may know why they call it the Centralized Intelligence Agency. It might be more appropriately called the Wireless Global Brain Project, created in 1947. They constrict knowledge and decide when and who will disseminate information or disinformation of their choosing through traditional media streams. We also know why CIA agents are called spooks. It is because their first scripts were all based on hauntings and possessions when testing the EEG heterodyning technology. Another stupid alien trick. Boo. It's Colonel Casper the Ghost, the main hive participant says as he taps himself on the shoulder, which I feel, and turn around. Laughter ensues. Dreams and harvesting the wet nets. 2 years prior to my 1 year torture and mentalization, I stopped dreaming or stopped remembering my dreams. It didn't disturb me. It was merely a curious note. I heard an analysis that only 15 years ago that all the world's computers combined didn't equal the computing power of one human brain. I do not know how the author derived it. But I surmise that it was based on the fact that the brain has 1 trillion synaptic connections, and assuming a human used their full capacity that each synapse would equal 1 transistor. Well, imagine if that were true, we could harness the down cycles of every human brain while people are sleeping. Like with the distributed grid computing frameworks such as SETI or Globus, the unused human computing power could be harnessed for unbelievably powerful distributed computations. Dividing a problem up for distributed computing might have the subjective experience of dreaming to an individual. Parts of the brain being used to calculate partial problems where the results would seem nonsensical and non-sequitorial in a conscious state. Becoming Borg. Let's look at the collective conscious of the human race. Communication amongst people can be thought of as signal transmission analogous to synaptic transmissions in the brain. Throughout the last century, we have been speeding up the communication and growing connections through the telecommunication infrastructure from email to mobile phones. The Earth is becoming more aware and conscious. When you speed up information flow from one person to the other, the ideas become more integrated to the individual and the sense of self becomes blurred. Now continue this trend line into the future with brain-to-brain interfacing technologies. The communications are even faster and more efficient. The distinction of information flow and storage becomes more amorphous. The physical housing of the brain is still well defined and segmented, but the soul, the information that you experience, becomes less and less tangible and distinguishable as to where the boundaries are. We will become the Borg. Now the question is, will it be designed with a centralized intelligence or be like the Internet, a free-forming and evolving self-organizing distributed intelligence? Elements in the government obvious prefer the former, which is clearly suboptimal according to evolution and optimization theory. Mankind is obsolete. The futurists all predicted that we would have our own robot slaves by now doing our work for us while we relaxed and could do anything we wished due to the prosperity. In a twist of fate, we humans turned out to be the robots with the machines enslaving us. As long as we don't become too aware of the inconsistencies of the system and keep our minds on our little job, work hard for the machines in exchange for points, hopefully we can live our entire lives without being pulled out of the delusion. We are the land of the free and brave, with people afraid of their own government. From another perspective, how long will humans be cheaper than machines to do any task? Ask yourself truthfully, do you see a computer or machine doing your job as well as you 10 years from now? I have analyzed the largest companies in the world in a management consultant role, the most sophisticated computer systems, and worked in almost every corporate function at some point. I assure you that automation of your tasks is not far away. Right now, the United States economy has been shifting to a service-oriented economy. Will the human race be downsized? Noah's Ark. A disturbing theory that has been postulated and repeated many times by those involved in watching the government is that there appears to be a plan for a major population decrease. DNA samples are being cataloged for every species on the planet and unique brains are being cataloged into the CIA/DOTAMI network. The cataloging may not just be to improve the cloning capabilities for spying and warfare. It may be a justification that not that much will be lost for global population genocide. The Earth cannot support the projected population growth. Resources will run out. So a plausibly denied event might be planned. A terrorist releases an airborne virus. Rogue countries decide on nuclear war. It is difficult to guess exactly how it would be architected to look like another group was responsible for it. It is something to keep in mind for the next 50 years while world events unfold. Since silicon immortality isn't that far away, a decrease in population might be justified for that reason. Most life will do anything to survive. If it were known that immortality is being rolled out to a few very rich people, desperate people may do anything to get it. Or if it could be given to everyone simultaneously, the planet would always remain crowded yet might be another concern. The ego trip. In Arnold Schwarzenegger's movie Total Recall, there is a false memory implantation technology that uses magnetic coils around the head. This is one way that brain waves can be modified as being researched by several academic institutions and labs. In this application, he wants to take a vacation to Mars. He elects an option of the virtual experience called the ego trip. Why be yourself on this trip? EEG heterodyning causes an alteration in personality, some weighted combination of all the people in the hive mind. I was shown that personality overlays can be captured from one person and replayed onto someone else. The ego trip really exists. It is a capture of temperament and emotional state mix and can be inserted by the computer interface onto the whole hive mind or just individuals. This aspect of EEG heterodyning has unusual applications for empathizing with other people. Don't judge someone until you walk a mile with their brain waves. How about the application of self-improvement? Don't want to be shy with the ladies anymore, just put on a personality overlay. Wives can finally make their husbands understand them better. Enemies can resolve their misunderstandings and differences. The list is endless just for this particular aspect of full brain communication. For the spy community, it can help them more easily infiltrate organizations with a particular belief system and mindset so that they are less likely to be discovered by subtle voice intonations and body language cues. Judgment Day. The current evil uses of EEG heterodyning can all be turned around. Rather than ruining the concept of justice by manipulating witnesses, judges, and juries or by committing crimes that can't be traced back to the person's will who cloned his/her brainwaves onto someone else, the technology allows the judge to understand the sincerity of the accused. truth can be more easily interpreted. Prisoners could be released under psychic surveillance parole. Sentenced people could opt for mental reprogramming rather than incarceration. Rather than being the number one nation in the world for incarcerating our people, we could be the freest nation through use of the technology. All these benefits are predicated on being able to awaken the world to its existence, thereby taking it out of military top secret status so that civilian commercialism and development can commence. Philosophy of consciousness. The keepers of EEG heterodyning technology fear that there will be a breakdown of social order, a vast moral cataclysm, and dissolution of religion around the world if it were known that the brain has been deciphered. People are resistant to the idea that our soul, our entire essence, is contained in the electrochemical signals of the brain. However, I disagree. I believe that religions will adapt as will morality to the better understanding of ourselves. There are two important ethical and legal questions that arise from this. How can we be held responsible for our actions if we are purely a product of genetics and stimuli from the environment? If the government is messing around with the electrical signals of the population's brains, how can anyone be charged for any crime given the unknowns of their experimentation? How can we even trust ourselves and our own thoughts if we know that they can be manipulated electromagnetically? Notes. Philosophical thought experiments in psychophysics. Transporter problem. Operating table. Wireless connections. Freedom and choice defines living. More E.